Good morning students, in this video we are going to learn chapter 5 lines and angles. In your earlier classes already learn about what is a line segment, angle, ray, etc. Let's recall that. First, what is a line segment? A line segment has, first consider two points and a straight line connecting these two points. That is, a line segment has two end points. Name it as AB. Then name of this line segment is AB, a small line. Now, if we extend the two end points on either direction endlessly, we get a line. That means, if we extend like this on both sides, the line segment become a line. Then it is denoted as AB like this. On either sides, the line has no end points. That means we can extend this on both sides indefinitely. Now, if a line has one starting point and on the other side, mark this point as P and this as Q. And other side, if we extend this indefinitely, then it become a ray. The starting point is Q. Point Q is the starting point of this ray. It is represented as Q, P. What is an angle? An angle is formed when lines or line segment meet. For example, in page number 94, the angle is formed when lines or line segment meet. That is, consider these two lines PQ and RS. They meet at point A. Then these lines form four angles. 1, 2, 3, 4. These are the four angles made by these two lines. Now, similarly, if two line segments are meet, it again forms an angle. In this figure, the first angle is this. Name of that angle is angle SOQ. The meeting point always at the middle. Name of this angle, angle QOR. Name of this angle, angle ROP. Name of this angle, angle SOP. Now consider the triangle ABC. Here the line segment forms the angle. This angle is called angle A or angle BAC. This angle is called angle C or angle ACB. This angle is called angle B, or we can same angle A, B, C. These are the angles in this triangle. We know that how to measure an angle using protractor. Then measure of this angle, angle B, measure of angle BAC can be written as M. MBC, maybe it's a 60 degree. Then measure of angle BAC equal to 60 degree. Now you have already studied how to classify the angles as acute, obtuse or right angle. If the measure of an angle, if the measure of this angle is 90 degree, then this angle is called right angle. This is right angle. If the measure are less than 90 degree, like this, maybe it's 30 degree, then this angle is called acute angle. Now, if the angle whose measure are more than 90 degree and less than 180 degree are called obtuse angle. Maybe 120 degree. This is called obtuse angle. Now take page number 94, complementary angles. Complementary angle means when the sum of the measures of two angles is 90 degree, the angles are called complementary angles. Consider these two angles. Measure of this angle is 30 degree and measure of this angle is 60 degree. If we add 30 degree plus 60 degree, we get 90 degree. Then we can say that these two angles are complementary angles. Similarly, if this angle is 10 degree and another angle is 90 degree, sorry, 80 degree, then 80 plus degree plus 10 degree, we get 90 degree. Then we can say that these two angles are complementary angles. If these two angles are complementary angles, then we can say that 30 degree angle is the complement of 60 degree angle. Complement of 60 degree. Similarly, 10 degree angle is the complement of 80 degree angle. That means when add these two, we get 90 degree. Therefore, these two angles are complementary angles. Consider this 60 degree and 40 degree. If we add these two, we get 100 degree. Therefore, these are not complementary angles. Consider these two angles. The angles are complementary. Now consider 35 and 65 degree. Are these two angles complementary? No. Since if we add these two, we get 100. Therefore, they are not complementary, but these two angles are complementary angles. Now, page number 95. First question, can two acute angles be complement to each other? Yes, we have 45 degree plus 45 degree is equal to 90 degree. Therefore, two angles having 45 degree, they are complement to each other. Also, we have 30 degree plus 60 degree. Both are acute angles. They are complementary. Now, can two obtuse angles be complement to each other? Angle means more than 90 degree. Then it cannot happen. If one angle is 92 degree and consider another obtuse angle 100 degree, then we get 192 degree, not equal to 90 degree. Therefore, two obtuse angles cannot be complement to each other. Next, can two right angles be complement to each other? That's also not possible. If we add 90 plus 90, we get 180 degree. Therefore, they are not complement to each other. Therefore, only acute angles be complement to each other. Like 70 degree plus 20 degree, 40 degree plus 50 degree, like that. Now, what is the measure of the complement of each of the following angles? 45 degree complement angle 45. Complement angle of 65 degree. Complement angle of 65 degree to find subtract 65 from 90. Then we get 25 is the complement of 65 degree. Now, 41 degree. When subtract 41 degree plus 90 degree, we get 49 degree. Then 49 degree is the complement of 41 degree.